diamond on my neck, band on my wrist. Everyone who booed Drake at that Tyler festival, your mom doesn't deserve my meat. So you all know what happened. Drake was a surprise, a guest at Tyler's festival or his show. And Tyler also brought out a ton of other artists. He brought out Solange. I think he brought out Thundercat. He brought out ASAP Rocky. He brought out Lil Uzi. Earl Sweatshirt performed two unreleased songs that I thought were absolutely incredible. And I'm so upset that those didn't land on his new EP. But Drake's the one who got booed off stage. Like Eminem said, I've been chewed up and spit out and booed off stage, but I kept prominent, stepped right in the next cypher. Best believe somebody's paying to pop. Apparently, there was a buildup to this show, to this festival, to this showcasing that led fans of Tyler, the Creator, to believe that Frank Ocean might be performing. He might be the quote-unquote question mark guest that they were alluding to in promotion for this thing months prior. So when a lot of them showed up, they were kind of expecting the surprise guest to be Frank Ocean. Now, from what I've been told from a lot of people that decided to DM me after the fact, hey, we didn't really have that much of a problem with Drake performing in the beginning, but he went on for a long time, kind of going into what we thought would be Frank Ocean's set. Again, Frank Ocean was never confirmed. Drake came out initially and said, hey, I'm going to do two or three songs. They told me to do two or three songs, and he kept going for more time, leading some people to believe, Frank Ocean fans specifically, to believe that he was stalling. And then after he got done and after they booed him off stage, they ended the show. See, I guess my problem with what happened wasn't that Drake did what he did. It was that it shouldn't have happened in the first place. Just like a lot of people believe that you can have a terrible performer, you can have a terrible audience. And there's a thing called concert etiquette, where you don't heckle the person that is on stage. You don't boo the person that's on stage. If you're at a show, you're at an event, or you're at a festival, unless the person is R. Kelly or 6ix9ine, you let them do their thing and let the next person come on. If you're not feeling the artist that's on stage at that time, you wait it out or you leave. Well, let me know that a lot of people that went to the concert have no etiquette, have no guideline or no ethics that they follow, even when it comes to listening to music in a live setting, which led me to believe that a lot of people who were there, outside of a ton of you guys that I'm sure probably attended and were cool about Drake performing and were even cool about him going over the amount of time that he initially said that he was gonna go. A lot of those people that were there, I'm sure, don't really interact socially with too many people, given that a lot of the music that Odd Future made early on was kind of made for an antisocial outcast type of group. So it would make sense that people that aren't that socially active would have a hard time following etiquette or some type of ethic protocol. One of the reasons I find dealing with fan bases that attach themselves to the artist so strongly, as people who tend to be antisocial do, end up being such a problem, because they attach themselves to people they feel represented by, and that representation gives them a sense of strength or a sense of purpose, like they're contributing to the world or to the artists themselves. That was my first issue, just the ethics of the entire thing. My second issue was how entitled this group of people must be to boo an artist, one of the largest artists in the world. And again, this is coming from a guy that I'm not the biggest fan of Drake. I'm not. But if I was at a West Side Gun show, or let's say something else. Maybe I'm at a Rock Marciano show, or I'm at an MF Doom show, and he brings out Drake, or he brings out 50 Cent, or he brings out Kanye West. Although it'd be odd, and although those demographics probably don't, you know, go into each other very well, I'm sure most of the people that are sitting there watching him perform that are there for Rock Marciano or there for MF Doom aren't going to be like, yo, get off the stage. They're going to have some etiquette. Those fans doing what they did at Tyler's show is, to me, equivalent to going to see Michael Jackson, him marketing his festival to make maybe people believe that Whitney Houston might perform, only to realize that Bob Dylan was there instead. Are you going to boo Bob Dylan? Now, I'm not comparing Drake and Tyler to Michael Jackson and Bob Dylan. I would never do that. But to sit there and just have this unnecessary distaste for Drake as if he's done something morally wrong to any of the people there or in general is just crazy to me. Sure, you might not have been expecting Drake, but to boo him off stage is just so tacky to me. And you make Tyler, the Creator, look bad. As his fans, you unintentionally represent the artist, because again, you feel represented by this guy, and the artist in a lot of ways feels represented by their fan base. So Tyler would have to probably make amends with Drake or let him know, hey, don't take anything personally. That wasn't supposed to happen. They weren't supposed to respond that way. I totally thought something else was, I thought they would be more receptive. Side issue I have with this, people are trying to bring up Drake's past with women as a justification as to why he got booed on stage, as if him texting a 14 or 15 year old, and we have nothing further to go off of than that, as to an indication that he's somehow grooming young, really, really young girls, or he's, you know, in some type of pedophilia, completely disregarding the fact that Tyler had Solange perform, who we have video evidence of assaulting Jay-Z in an elevator, but now Drake is the one that's morally in question here. And I'm not saying Solange should be canceled. I'm just saying that's a really dumb justification to say he should get booed when she didn't. Fourth issue with this, Tyler is at the biggest point of his career right now. If we're being honest, and we're talking to me from a couple years ago, probably back in 2013, my career trajectory for Tyler, the creator, was make a couple albums, stay C, B list at best rapper, and then fizzle out. That was his trajectory up until he started making more music that embraced a bit more of an emotional edge to it. And we got Flower Boy. We got Igor. Now we have this whole new marketed persona, right? A whole new evolved personality. And I don't think he ever thought he would be as big as he is right now. So for him to get Drake, one of the, if not biggest rapper in the world, to perform at his festival probably meant the world to him. And it's probably him giving it to his fans like, look at what I've achieved. Look at what I've accomplished. This is all thanks to all that we've built, that I got somebody this huge to come and be a part of something about me. And y'all gonna boo him? And to close the video out, I guess, with my final issue of what happened, is this strange sense of entitlement people have when it comes to these artists. I really get why so many of them go crazy now, because it's ridiculous that you don't have to say anything and people can fill their minds up with ideas, basing it off of nothing, go with a narrative. And if it doesn't happen, they're mad at people that never said any of that thing and never said any of that stuff was happening in the first place. How entitled do you have to be that instead of getting someone who's large and who you love, you get someone who's just as way bigger? What happened is like the equivalent of getting a gaming PC for Christmas that'll last you 10 plus years, that has amazing specs, that can not only handle 4K streaming and get all your games and watch all your movies and, I don't know, send you to the moon, and you saying, no, I didn't want that, I expected a MacBook, and you hand it back. It's the equivalent to spitting at someone's feet when they give you something that was from the heart and you say, nah, I didn't want that, I wanted this. The entitlement is through the roof. And it lets me know that Tyler Creator's fans aren't hip hop fans. They're Tyler the Creator fans. They're Brockhampton fans. They're Frank Ocean fans. They're Odd Future fans. Many of these people who attend don't even care to listen to hip hop. They're there because this artist represents a piece of who they are, and they don't listen to hip hop more than that. That's me speaking for that small minority that was there, that was booing Drake and egging him to get off stage. I'm sure a lot of people who were Tyler the Creator fans also love hip hop. They also attended because they saw, okay, we got Rocky now, we got Uzi now, we got Drake now. I'm sure they didn't care that much. But if you were there and you were participating and you look like this, you are a Z-tier citizen. At best, you are an NPC player in a video game. Moral of the story is, treat people with respect, even if they're not the person that you want to see. Even if they're not the person that you expected. Just have some etiquette, have some class, have some respect, and just let it go. If the next time this happens and there's someone that comes on the stage and you were, this is just assuming that there may be a Tyler Creator stand that attended that also booed. I'm sure majority of y'all that are watching have no idea what I'm talking about. And if you do, you may have attended and you probably didn't do what most of these other people did. But if you're there, you see it, just let them complete their set. You can either leave, you can stay and look bored, but don't boo. That's like the worst thing you can do. Have some class, all right? Get some help. Stop it.